The Problem with APU is a 2017 documentary written by and starring comedian Hari Kondabolu. The premise is pretty straightforward as Hari explains his issues with the character of Apu Nahasapimapenalon portrayed in The Simpsons, and interviews many well-known Western South Asians. Apart from being a stereotypical representation of a South Asian immigrant in both character and appearance, a key issue of Hari's, and mine, is a digital brown face, with the voice actor Hank Azaria being white and putting on an accent. Spoilers, but in the end, Hari doesn't get the chance to speak with Azaria one-on-one, at least to get his insight. South Asians, primarily in Western countries, have been mocked because of this, and many of us have accepted Apu as the way things are and will be because we've been so starved for representation. And so when Hari doesn't get the closure of holding Hank's feet to the fire, I felt that as well. Around 4 months after the documentary was released, this segment was written into a new Simpsons episode.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
It's hard to say. Something that started decades ago and was applauded and inoffensive is now politically incorrect. What can you do?
Some things will be dealt with at a later date.
If at all.
If at all.
If it's not apparent, it's a distinctly tone-deaf response that's a middle finger to those with concerns about Apu's portrayal and The Simpsons' racist portrayals of people of colour in the series. A week later, Hank did Damage Control on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert.
So what do you make of the show's response? And did you have anything to do with that?
I did not. I had nothing to do with the writing or voicing. Apu doesn't speak in that segment. It was a late addition that I saw right around the same time that everybody else in America did. So I didn't know what was going to be in it until I saw it. I think that if anybody came away from that segment feeling that they should lighten up or take a joke better or grow a thicker skin or
toughen up. That's what people said, we've heard what you said and we were not gonna respond.
Yeah, that's certainly not the way I feel about it. And that's definitely not the message that I wanna send.
What do you think should happen with the character going forward?
Yeah, I've given this a lot of thought, really a lot of thought. And as I say, my eyes have been opened. And I think the most important thing is we have to listen to South Asian people, Indian people in this country, when they talk about what they feel and how they think about this character and what their American experience of it has been. And as you know, in television terms, listening to voices means inclusion in the writer's room. I really want to see Indian, South Asian writers in the room, not in a token way, but genuinely informing whatever new direction this character may take, including how it is voiced or not voiced. You know, I'm perfectly willing and happy to step aside or help transition it into something new. I really hope that's what The Simpsons does. And it not only makes sense, but it just feels like the right thing to do to me.
Hank does fall on his sword in a way, but somebody who has earned millions of dollars, in part because of his portrayal of this character, can do a lot more with his money and social capital than apologies. He's likely sincere, but a well-scripted interview doesn't fix things immediately. While there are conflicting accounts of who created or approved Apu's accent, the fact of the matter is that Hank, show creator Matt Groening, and the team at Fox have been complicit in marginalizing South Asians for over 30 years, regardless of whether you think anything and everything can be joked about. Now in January this year, Hank said he'd be stepping down, which was long overdue, but welcome. Groening said the show would still have Apu, but made no further comments on how and voiced by whom. Talk about white actors voicing people of colour in animated form went silent for a couple of months then. Then in May, George Floyd was murdered in cold blood by Minneapolis police. Black Lives Matter has existed for many years, but the protests and riots that happened following Floyd's death have cut through a lot of the white silence. And more people are being held accountable by friends, family, and fans about their complicity in a system which disproportionately murders black people worldwide. Following a lot of tokenistic neoliberal support for Black Lives Matter in response, like black squares, hashtags, and platitudes, we had this. And you might think, hey, you should be happy, right? This is good. And yet somewhat good, but for these actors and companies, it's pretty much just optics. These actors knew what they were doing, or at least charitably, actively stuck their head in the sand for as long as it was viable for their celebrity status. So that really brings me to the point of this video. For the most part, these new digital brown-faced characters have learned from Apu and stripped back the obvious stereotypical accents, but they lack the authenticity and agency of actual people of colour, as well as being written by majority white writers. Black, Indigenous, and people of colour deserve to have our stories told just as much as white people, but we're also fighting for our fucking lives. Black and Native Americans are incarcerated, brutalized, and killed by the American state. In my home country of Australia, Indigenous Australians are also subject to this disgusting abuse. In my mother country of Sri Lanka, my fellow Tamils have also been treated similarly by the Sinhala Buddhist Chauvin estate, and these are just the three that I have the most knowledge about, and I didn't even get into historic genocide. This happens all across the world to black and brown bodies by states. I'd also say Hari is not immune to critique. I don't want to play a game of association, but there are a couple of people interviewed in this film who have contributed to white supremacy. Actor Cal Penn and Dr. Vivek Murthy worked for Obama while he was president, the same president who really did jack all for police reform and continued killing countless civilians via drone strikes in the Middle East. Penn and Murthy's complicity, support, and working relationship with Obama has wrought more evil in the world than APU ever could. Now, this channel was created to represent the types of stories and people that I thought weren't being acknowledged. So you already know that representation is incredibly important to me. But without actionable steps like changing the systems that create and enforce white supremacy, we're really just taking one step forward and two steps back. While I don't think for a second that my videos have been apolitical, I'm going to make more of a concerted effort to speak truth to power where it matters. Malcolm X has many incredible quotes, but one that sparked this video was, "The white man will try and satisfy us with symbolic victories rather than economic equity and real justice." And these concessions by white actors are at the moment just perfunctory. Think about how with your actions, not just your words, you can contribute to a more just society. The problem with APU is not the whole problem. It's the tip of the fucking iceberg. Black Lives Matter.